I'll always remember how I felt the first time I saw Pascal. We hadn't even met before, but I remember him walking into my sociology class, I believe it was, and the instant I saw him, I was like, oh my God, this guy is perfect. He had all the looks, the style, he even had the attitude.
I definitely remember the first time that Brent approached me and introduced himself to me. And how I felt about it then is, hey, that's just another guy. He seems interested in me. Like, I saw through him. Like, he was so transparent in the way he was acting. It was obvious that he was interested in me. And at the time, I was way different than I am right now.
It took me a couple of weeks until I actually approached him. I talked about this in another video. It was in a psychology class and there was a group oral, and I asked him to join our group and he said yes. And all the while I was so nervous. Sort of like when, you're starstruck in front of somebody who's, bigger than life to you. And that's what he represented to me, even though I didn't know him yet.
I'd say the time that it really impacted me was when I went out for the first time with Brian in Montreal and with other friends of his. And the night we spent together surprised me so much. And from that night onward, I knew that it would be a part of my life, but I didn't knew yet that it would be the one I would be living with right now. And I've spent so much time together. Like, at the time, I just knew it would be part of my life, but I didn't know exactly how or what role it would play in my life.
Once I got to know him even better, the stress sort of faded and was a lot more comfortable being around him, and I think he was comfortable being around me. And we were open and honest with each other about things in our lives. We would talk about personal things, and then one thing led to another. We would start seeing each other more intimately. I remember the first time I went to his house. It was a night after work, and it was very intimate. It was cozy and he was sweet. He was super caring and nice, and we just talked and we snuggled a little bit, and then we slept, and then we went back to school together the next morning. And from that time on, we never left each other's side.
I definitely wasn't in love with him at first sight. I think for Brian, his experience would be like love at first sight, but me, it was the contrary. I think the love I have for Brian now grew over the years through all the experience we had together and all the things we've shared. And this has surprised me so much because I would never have thought that at first this was possible, because I have been in love with many other guys before, and it was always love at first sight. I didn't knew them personally that much, but like it was an instant, like lightning struck, like the classic love, you know? But for Brian, it definitely grew over the years, and I think a love like that is so much stronger because you love that person for a reason. Not just because you think they're beautiful or anything, it's like everything culminating together makes what that person is special for you.
To be quite honest, I did think that we would be a couple, that we would be in a relationship, but the thing is, I never thought that it would have lasted. And I was right. The first time we dated lasted about a week, and then it was finished, but then we became good friends. Probably because I never thought I was sort of quote unquote dating material. But no, I mean, when we were friends for a good 2 years, it didn't feel any different than if we were boyfriends. We would do everything together, we would go on trips, we would see each other constantly and regularly, just like any other normal couple would. So I don't think that I missed anything in my life. Had I been in a couple with Pascal, I don't think it would have been any different. It was just the feeling that, oh, he's not my boyfriend, that really bothered me a little bit. So when we did become a couple, of course I was super exhilarated and very happy and excited. But no, I had a wonderful 2 years just being friends with Pascal.
Would I say that Brian is the right one for me? Definitely. because I know for sure, it's been, around 7 or 8 years now that we've been together, and I think I would not be able to find someone that would love me as much as he can love me, and he's taken care of me so many times now, because as you know, we've shared it a bit on this channel, my health issues, I had several health issues over the past years, and Brian has always been there for me, and I know that in the future, if anything happens, he'll be there, and I think he can take care of me, and he is good for me, and not many people can say that, but I know I can, and I think because of that, Brian is definitely the right one for me. I couldn't have found better.
I'm very young, I'm still only just 25 years old. I can't say I've been in a ton of relationships in my short life, but I did have a few relationships, not very serious, but one that was just, a month and a half of dating and a couple of weeks, and others is just, flings. So I can't really say that during those periods of my life, I felt like that person was the one. With Pascal, as soon as we began dating, I really did think that he was the right one for me. And that was even during the time that we sort of broke up. I always knew that he was going to be the one for me, just because I felt we had so much in common and so many similar interests that it would be so hard for us to separate from one another, and we became so attached to each other that it was just, almost like destiny. And I don't believe in that stuff, but I couldn't see myself living my life without Pascal by my side.
I know many of you are watching, often you comment that you guys are so lucky, you're together. Many of you are still struggling to find the right one, or even just a regular boyfriend, or someone that can love you or you can love them. I know it's difficult, and I know me and Brian are very lucky to have each other, because some people will pass through their life and try to find the right one. Some of them will succeed, some of them won't. But what I can say, what I can tell you from advice is sometimes the right one for you is closer than you think.
Talking from experience, I can honestly say that finding the right one is possible. But you really have to be careful. You don't want to rush through that experience. You don't want to go looking for it. Because if I can give you a piece of advice, it will come to you. You just have to wait it out a little bit. I had to wait a few years until Pascal and I finally became boyfriends. So it's sometimes a long wait. For some people, it can be a very short wait, but I do believe that it will come to anyone and everyone.
I love you.